El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Elyon Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same, by the power of your name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Kamkon Adonai. I will praise and lift you high, El Shaddai. Through your love and through the ram, you saved the son of Abraham.
Hey, 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 and praise God for this glorious day. This is Zach Mitchum, your host of What Jesus Says. I want to welcome you back and being so faithful and joining us every Friday at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to learn more about what Jesus has to say on controversial issues facing us today. This is the day the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad, and we're so glad to have you back. Look, things are looking up. I think we're on our way to getting a favorable situation with our country. We got our captives back, and we set it the captives free, and we're talking about restoration tonight. So restoration, I'm glad to have our people back, and we're looking up. So let's keep God in mind when we thank him for doing all the things that he's done for us in our country, and just to get us back to a place where we just are normal again, and as we are, and continue with this normalcy and not go back to crazy. We don't want to go back to crazy at all. So think about that. It's worth the sacrifice if you're paying a little more for whatever. But we can't go back. We got to just go forward and pursue the Lord with all of our heart, and he'll direct our path. So let's go to the Lord in our prayer. Lord God, we thank you, Jesus, for all the many blessings you bestowed upon us. We pray for those that are less fortunate, those in hospitals, nursing homes, hospices, homeless shelters, those incarcerated, unemployed, even those that are on death row, that you give them peace. We pray for your apostles, prophets, evangelists, preachers, teachers, local and universal. We pray for your churches, local and universal. We pray for our president and vice president, that you give them wisdom and favor and guidance to lead this country. Pray for leaders all over the world. We pray for peace of Jerusalem, that we prosper, that love the holy city. Peace be in our gates, prosperity in our palaces. We pray for the salvation of Israel, that come to know as their God, Lord, and Savior, Jesus Christ. We pray for our enemies, that we might have peace and have them cease from troubling. We pray for our soldiers, sailors, airmen, marines, and all our men and women in uniform that stand watch over our safety, Lord Jesus. Now we turn this broadcast over to you, Jesus, that you get all the honor and glory that's due to you. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. Now look, if you want to participate in a nice conversation, it's very simple. All you have to do is dial 919-747-3572. Again, that number, if you want to participate, if that's you want to join our discussion, is 919-747-3572. And we'll be on the way shortly. 919-747-3572. Hey, 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 who do we have on the line today?
Hello.
Hey, who do we have on the line today? Okay, okay. We're looking forward to our discussion this evening. We got a good discussion going on.
All right.
Hey, who do we have on the line today? Hello?
Hello?
Hey, look, you got to answer the phone now. What's wrong with you?
What?
Are you answering the phone?
Yeah, I'm answering the phone.
I know you sound like you were taking a nap.
Well,
I guess you say you better be cool. You better be cool and leave me alone, huh?
Yeah, I'm doing fine. How are you doing today?
I'm blessed. I'm so blessed to be able to hear your voice. I love you. So I guess that's good for another nickel. You going to give me another nickel to go to Mr. Doc's store?
Hallelujah.
You remember you used to give me a nickel to go down to the store and get some cookies, 5 cents worth of cookies. That was a lot of cookies, wasn't it?
You haven't forgotten about that.
Because you get two for a penny, don't you?
Yeah. That's what we got two for. For Miss Ellen.
So what happened to those days?
Those days have passed and gone.
So you said old days are long gone. No more two for a penny, huh?
Yes, yes.
And those are the big old cookies, at least when I was a kid. They call them penny wheels. You remember that?
Penny wheels, yes.
Yeah. Mr. Doc, give me some penny wheels. I want 5 cents worth of penny wheels.
Yeah, you forgot that, Zach. You forgot the penny wheel.
You going to give me some penny wheels.
George and Miss Ellen.
Yeah. Give me 5 cents worth of penny wheels. Okay, here we go. Enough of this playing around. We supposed to be serious. You know we got to be serious, right?
Amen.
Okay, look, we talk about restoration tonight. You know what restoration is? Everything the enemy stole, he got to give it back. You know that, right?
Everything he stole, he got to give it back.
He got to give it back. I pray that prayer every morning. Everything the devil stole from my ancestors, relatives, and friends, me, past, present, and future, I want my stuff. I don't just want my stuff. I want yours, too. Because you might not be praying for your stuff. Do you pay for your stuff back to get it back?
Amen.
Amen. They sang the song, but they don't even understand. That's the word. He got to give it back. So these are the scriptures we're going to have, and then we're going to go ahead and get started. You ready?
Ready.
Okay, here we go. Lock, cock, ready to rock. John 10:10. We're talking about the description of the devil, what he's supposed to be doing and what Jesus does. We're talking about Joel 2, that's the second chapter of Joel, 25th verse. Malachi 3, third chapter, 11th verse. 1 Peter 5, 8. Proverbs 6, 31. Zechariah 9, 12. And we're going to end it up with Job 42, 9. Do you know everything in the Word of God is truly stated? But every statement in the Word is not a statement of truth. Do you understand what I mean by that?
No.
Every time the devil speaks, is there any truth to that?
No truth.
Because it's stated in the Word of God, isn't it? It's in there when the devil's talking, right? So when the Lord said when the devil speaks, he speaks a lie because he's the father of lies, right? So everything that's in the Word of God is not the truth. It's a statement of truth because whenever the devil's talking, he's lying, right? But he got to show you what the devil said in order for you to know how he twists the truth. Do you understand? That's why he told you to study to show yourself approved. A workman need not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. So if the devil is talking, we know ain't no truth to that, right?
No, no truth.
But the word is true, no doubt. He wrote it. I mean, in the word, that's what the devil said. And we take that as a truth, that the Lord clearly had it stated that that's what the devil said. Now, Job made some statements, and we're going to talk about that. But we're talking about restoration tonight. So if you want to participate in tonight's conversation, dial 919-747-3572. This is Zach Mitchum, your host of What Jesus Says. Let's get down with it. John 10:10. Let's give a description of what this devil's supposed to be doing. Now, all he's doing is what he's supposed to do, but you got a job too, right? He told you how to protect yourself. Like a military soldier, they teach you how to protect yourself, put your weapon together. Now, if you don't pay attention, you're going to end up like Bubba on Forrest Gump. You remember that? Bubba got shot up because he didn't pay attention, right?
Right.
And he was a casualty of war, was he not?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you mother didn't watch Forrest Gump. You don't even know who we talking about, do you, mother?
I saw the movie.
You saw the movie? Who is this I'm talking about?
Faith.
How'd you get on the phone?
I'm listening to you talk.
I know, but how you gonna sneak in? You knocked everybody off.
I don't answer the phone.
Okay, you still here? Okay. I see your daughter try to steal the broadcast sometimes. I don't know. I don't know. I think she's jealous about what Jesus said. She want to make give me the mic. Huh? Why you just can't be satisfied with giving the mic? You want everything. Why you like that, sister?
I love both of them.
Okay, well, I love you too, and we're going to get on this. But look, watch this. You remember Bubba didn't pay attention, so he was a casualty, right? So the same thing holds true if you don't pay attention. If you don't listen to what the Lord is telling you in his word, you're going to be a casualty. He tells you how to put on your whole armor, right?
Right.
You got your helmet on backward. You don't have your sword sharpened. You don't study. And then you're going to expect the devil to respect that. He's going to say, hey, go over there and get that one over there because he looked weak. And once he start whooping up on your head, he's like, Jesus, help me, Lord, Jesus. He said, what's wrong with you? Didn't I tell you to put on your armor? Hey, what? Look at your helmet, all twisted all into your belt and your sword. What's wrong with you? Get yourself together. And that's what the Lord has to do sometimes to get us together, right?
Right.
Right, have to let you go through it to get that equipment, to see how important it is to pay attention and get that equipment together, right?
Uh-huh.
So let's talk about it. John 10:10, the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. And this is Jesus talking. He said, I am come that they may have life, and they that might have it more abundantly. Again, the thief cometh not but to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. Line up. That's a quite opposite. That's direct opposition to what Jesus is doing. So God, whenever God is giving and good things are coming, that's from the Lord. But when somebody's stealing and taking and robbing and killing, that's of who? That's of the devil.
Yeah.
And so when people charge God foolishly, see, Job never charged God foolishly, but he had things taken from him. We're going to talk about that tonight. So when he tells you that, when that enemy does what he does, he's going to go into action. He's going to require restitution for all that stuff that's stolen, right? And let's see how he does that in Joel 2:25. He says, and I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten. That came from the devil. The cankerworm and the caterpillar and the plumber worm, my great army which I have sent among you, and ye shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God that has dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never be ashamed. Did he say his people were going to ever be ashamed? He said his people will never be ashamed. Now This is the thing. He's going to have the devil restore everything you just heard. The cankerworm, all of that. Once you discover who did it, and that's what happened with Job. Job, I wanted to wait to the last. Lord, don't let me get ahead. But this is what he tells us. He puts protection around us, and he rebukes the devourer. Let's read that. Malachi 3:11. Okay. Most times preachers trying to scare you to death to tithe in this Malachi 3, but they don't give you the good news, right? The good news is Jesus said, and I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. When you say to rebuke, he puts a hedge of protection around you. It's like when you got that off. What is that off? It's like a repellent, insect repellent. So we got a thing called sin repellent, right? You spray on that blood all over you every morning, and you got on a sin repellent. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
And Jesus said, and I will rebuke the devourer for your sake, and he shall not destroy the fruits of your ground, neither shall your vine cast her fruit before the time in the field, and says the Lord of hosts. and all nations shall call you blessed. Are you kidding me right now? So if you're not being called blessed, you're not following the instructions in the manual, huh? You know how you go to the store and buy you a box of cake mix? And if you follow the box of cake mix on whatever's on the cake box, you're going to get a what?
Cake.
You're going to get a cake. It's just that simple, right? Do they sell the cake mix box to black people?
Yes.
Do they sell the cake mix block to white people?
Yes.
What about good people? Do they sell cake mix box to good people?
Yes.
Bad people? Can they buy a cake mix box?
Yes.
So anybody that follows the instructions, they're going to get a what?
Cake.
Okay. You see how easy the word is to understand? Huh?
Yeah.
The Lord said he didn't just rain on the good, but the evil can too. So everybody partakes, but when it's time for the harvest, you didn't hear what I said. The Lord said, well, it's time for the harvest. Let them both grow up, the good and the evil. And then I'm going to separate the tare from the wheat, right? Huh? Well, lest you tear up the wheat too. Let them grow. And then I'm going to tell the reapers, I'm going to say, gather up all the tares, right? And put them in an oven to be burned. And then I'm going to tell them to carry up that wheat so we can store them in the barns for safekeeping. And that's what he tells you. Huh? So don't be envious of people. Don't be envious of evildoers, because God's got a plan in them. You're like, how did that dude prosper? That dude was the most evil dude in the such and such. And the devil got people he take care of, but it doesn't mean it's permanent, does it?
No.
Everybody following instructions on the cake box, they're going to get a cake. But one cake might be tainted. It might be, what do you call them thing? When you stick, mother used to stick a toothpick in the thing to see if the thing was ready, right?
Yeah.
You didn't think I was watching you when you were doing that goofy stuff, right? I was. Now, but you didn't take no toothpick. Now, I'm going to tell you what you had, and you're going to laugh what I tell you. It was one of them straws out of the broom.
Broomstick.
It was a straw out of the broom. You know how you take the little broom straw?
Right.
And you stuck it in the cake to see if the thing was sticking?
Right.
Huh? You remember them days?
Yeah, that was the day.
That was a long time ago, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We didn't even use no toothpick. Yeah, I was just a little boy. All right, let's see what he says in 1 Peter 5:8. He said, be sober. He's giving you a warning. He said, don't be drunk with wine in excess, but be filled with the Spirit. Be sober, he says. He said, be sober, be vigilant, because he tell you why now. You better get your arm and your equipment right and pay attention. He said, be sober, be vigilant. Hypervigilant, really, just like we learned in the military, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may destroy or devour. And he's not like a lion, because there are only one lion, the Lion of Judah, of the tribe of Judah, and that's Jesus Christ. He walk around like that lion and looking for the weak. Go grab that one. His helmet all jacked up and his belt all twisted. He don't know the word. He don't pray in the spirit. He don't do none of that. He'd say that's over the top. It don't take all that. But let me show him something. And when that whirlwind come on him and he's trying to ask for his mama, it's too late. Mama can't help you, right? Why does everybody call their mama when they're in trouble? I remember when I was jumping out of airplane calling my mama. She can't do that. She can't fly. You need to be calling Jesus, don't you? I'm jumping out of airplane. And I'm in the fetal position. First thing I'm calling on his mother. I'm like, Ma! And Jesus hit me in the head. You say, you better be calling me, because she can't fly. And I'm saying, Lord, have mercy, Jesus, help me. Help me how I get up here in this mess. And I'm jumping. God, that's the craziest thing I ever did in my life, right? But that's the way life is. You got to study. He said, be sober. Be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. So be steadfast in the faith. And don't get caught up with the things of the world, because that's all the world does. They do what they're supposed to do. And y'all get all wrapped around and ask about the world. Okay, let me give you an example, right? How the devil stole your joy. Here you are watching the Olympics, rooting for your country, and the opening ceremony. And all these so-called religious, Christian, evangelical, da, da, da. Oh, this is a heresy. This is a founder, da, 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 da. I said, you're the biggest morons I've ever seen in my life. Now, you would have thought you would have one deep thinker in that whole group, right? This is a travesty. It's an abomination. Having all these gay folks running around trying to talk about. Okay, when the Lord said you better take the log out of your eye before you take the speck out of your adversary's eye, right? Watch this. In Exodus, the 20th chapter, the 4th verse, all you religious evangelicals done got ticked off about something you ain't even supposed to have, a picture of God, right? So now you upset of somebody that painted a picture of supposed to be God. So that's a sin. You know that, right? So they're angry about something that's just about like being angry if somebody ticked off Santa Claus. Have you ever seen God?
No.
Have you seen a picture of God?
No.
Okay, so how are you going to get angry about something that don't even supposed to exist? You see how easy the devil stole the joy from the United States to celebrate the Olympics instead of somebody with some kind of, they went to all these colleges, universities, cemeteries, I'm seeing seminary. So, but why should I get upset on that? That ain't even a picture. That's some rendition that Michelangelo or whatever. That ain't Jesus. That ain't the disciples. That's just how he figured they would look. And you supposed to get angry about that? First off, like I said, you want to put these commandments in the classroom, and you violating the number one commandment. You see how goofy that is? Here you talk about, well, we done made an image of Jesus. That's Jesus. How you figure that a picture of a European is supposed to be Jesus, and the word never said that Jesus ever been to Europe? You understand? So you see how ludicrous that is? So don't get caught up in the things of the world. The world's going to do what the world does, right? I'm going to play this thing, and then we're going to come right back. And before you know it, we're going to have to close out. Isn't that something? We got long-winded. Okay. So when you've done all you can do, this is what the brother told us. He told us to stand, right?
When you've done all you can and it seems like it's never enough, and what do you say when your friends turn away and you're all alone, all alone? Tell me, what do you give when you give it? Stand, watch the Lord see you through. Yes, after you've done all you can, you just stand. Tell me, how do you handle the guilt of your past? Tell me how. Filled with pain,
child, you just stand when there's nothing left to do. You just stand once the Lord see you through. Yes, after you've done all you can, you just stand and be sure you're not entangled in that bondage of.
Watch the Lord see you through. After you've done all you can do, just stand. He's going to restore you back to your last known good state. You understand? Just like David, he said, restore your holy, withdraw not your Holy Spirit from me, but restore in me a clean heart, renew a right spirit in me. His recovery, restoration, amen? Now watch this. If you want to know that kind of restoration, he says in Romans 10:9, if you confess with your mouth, Lord Jesus, believe in your heart, God raised him from the dead, then you're saved. Because with the mouth, confession is made to salvation, and with the heart, belief is made unto righteousness. And we believe that. And then we also believe in Luke 11:13, that you being evil know how to give your children good gifts. How much more will your Heavenly Father give you the Holy Ghost if you ask him? And that's all you have to do is ask him, and he'll give you the Holy Spirit. Amen. So we got this last few scriptures, and we're going to close out tonight. Look. In Proverbs 6:31, it says, but if he is found, he's talking about the adversary, the devil. He said, but if he is found, he shall restore sevenfold. He shall give all the substance of his house. If that thing that was vexing you has taken from you, he's got to give it back. And he gives the restoration example in Job, where he tells you in Job 2:25, and this is what the Lord said. He said, and I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten and the canker. That's Joel. Job. Let's go to Job. And he said in Job 42:10, and the Lord turned the captivity of Job when he prayed for his friends. Also, the Lord gave Job twice much as he had before. So whatever happened to Job, he restored twice. He multiplies. He add to you. He multiplies. Amen. Okay, anybody want to summarize what we talked about? Okay, so what should your grade be?
My grade should be 100.
We're looking forward to you again next week for another edition of What Jesus Says, and we thank you for your continued support. So until next.
Oh, teach me, Master. Master, teach me. Oh, teach me how to wait. To say, oh, I would not live a liar. I'll tell you the reason why. Teach me, come on, Master.
Teach me, Master.
You know that sound good right now. Listen.
Teach me.
Oh, teach
me how to pray.
For I would not be a gambler, and I'll tell you the reason why. Oh yeah, I'm afraid right now that Jesus might call my name. Oh yeah, and I would be ready. Teach me, oh, teach me, Master.
Teach me,
come on, Master.
Teach me, Master. Teach me,
come on, Jesus.
Teach me, Master. Teach me.
Teach me to pray.
Teach me, Master. Teach me.
Teach me to walk right.
Teach me, Master. Teach me.
Teach me to talk right.
Teach me, Master. Teach me.
Oh, teach me how to pray.
Teach me what
joining us. We look forward to having you again next week on another edition of What Jesus Says. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.